name is Dr. Amy Clements Cortez, and I'm pleased to bring you this tutorial on the role of music therapy in relationship completion at end of life. Here is a little bit of information about me. I graduated with an undergraduate degree in music therapy from the University of Windsor, and my master's and PhD degrees are from the University of Toronto, both in Canada. I work one day, continually now, as a music therapist, providing care to those in palliative care, those with cognitive impairments and dementia, as well as those that are requiring mental health support. I'm also a registered psychotherapist, hold additional certification as a fellow in the Association of Music and Imagery, as well as being trained in neurologic music therapy. I teach at the University of Toronto, Wilfrid Laurier University, and Ryerson University. I also believe in giving back to the music therapy community. I'm pleased to say that I just completed my term as the president of the World Federation of Music Therapy, and I now serve the federation as past president. I'm the managing editor of the Music and Medicine Journal, and also sit on a number of journal review boards. So let's get right to it. Here's an overview of what you'll be hearing about in the tutorial today. So you're going to get an overview of palliative care music therapy. We'll take a look at the techniques that are used in palliative care music therapy. Then we'll look at the emerging themes that have come out of palliative care music therapy. This is from a scoping review of the literature that I recently did. We'll look at the Dilio and Denister model of music therapy in palliative care. And then we'll look at the research and descriptive literature that support the emerging themes as well as work within this Dilio and Denister model. I'm going to present a case study to you as part of a research study that I did, and then we're going to look at what the implications are for music therapists in terms of doing this work. And finally, we'll end off with some ideas for future research and talk about the bonus content. So why is this topic important? Because there is an increasing need with services for palliative care. So as the population continues to age, there will be more people that will be needing to access palliative care services. And we know that music therapy can have such an impact on enhancing quality of life at end of care. It's also important to demonstrate the efficacy of the use of music therapy for persons at end of life. And we know that music therapy can assist with so many goals at this stage. And then also to grow the specialty and the discipline of music therapy in palliative care, and with specific focus today on relationship completion. So the learning outcomes are outlined on your slide. They are to learn about palliative care music therapy techniques, and the emergent themes of practice in palliative care. To learn about the Dilio and Denister model of palliative care. To learn about relationship completion, and the importance of this work with patients at end of life. To understand the process of music therapy facilitated relationship completion through the presentation of a case study. And to engage in this work and future investigations.